Enrichment is one of the classic steps in processing of text data, and tagging is a type of enrichment. Tagging is the application of information to individual tokens, perhaps classifying them as a named entity, applying parts of speech, or assigning sentiment. There are several tagger nodes available in KNIME Analytics platform to help with this process, including the POS tagger, Stanford NLP NE tagger, wildcard tagger, dictionary tagger, and more. Before we get started, it's important to point out that tagging is performed on full sentences treated as single strings. After tagging, these sentences need to be tokenized again, since all tagger nodes require a tokenization algorithm as well as document type input and output columns. All these settings have been collected in a single tab in the configuration window of all tagger nodes. Let's first take a look at ways we could tag words in our text with parts of speech. Part of speech, or POS tags, are useful for information retrieval and word sense disambiguation. Words are ambiguous, which means that they can have more than one possible part of speech. For example, delay could be a verb, the flight will be delayed at the gate for 2 or more hours, or a noun, possible delay in delivery is due to external factors. Thus, the goal of POS tagging is to resolve these ambiguities, choosing the proper tag for the context. As a practical matter, sometimes it is useful to apply POS tags for filtering purposes later, in the case where we think nouns, adjectives, and adverbs carry more meaning for our task than, say, prepositions or conjunctions. There are two main nodes in KNIME that perform this tagging, the POS tagger and the Stanford tagger. In this workflow, let's apply the POS tagger node to some movie reviews from the IMDb dataset. The POS tagger works only for English text and assigns parts of speech using the Penn Treebank tag set. In the configuration dialog, we just choose the document column of interest, whether we want to replace the existing document, the tokenizer, and the number of parallel tagging processes we want to enable, to potentially improve execution time. We could have also used the Stanford tagger to perform the same task. It assigns tags using models developed by the Stanford NLP group and is not limited to English text. Several different languages are supported, as well as different sequence models that you can choose from. As you can see here, the general options are the same as the POS tagger, but there is an additional tab in the configuration dialog for model selection. You'll need to choose the model based on language, desired computational effort, and best accuracy. Here we'll use the default English left 3 words. That was easy, but how do we actually see the new tags we've applied? You'll notice that when examining the output data table of a text processing node, document type cells are not easy to inspect, since the whole content of the document is hidden behind the title or the first words. For a deeper inspection, you could use a document viewer node, or extract the words one by one using a bag of words node. For now, let's instead try the tagged document viewer node. In its configuration, we just specify the document column of interest, making sure that the display document tags box is checked. When we open its view, we see a rather colorful display of all the words in the first review, tagged and color-coded with their associated parts of speech. Here I see a noun, here a verb, and so on, according to the Penn Treebank tag set. I can also change the pagination to review multiple documents on the same page by clicking here. Let's sum up. Here we've learned a bit about tagging, which is one of the ways you can enrich your dataset in a text analytics project. In KNIME, we've discussed several different tagging nodes you can use, depending on the type of analysis you're setting up. We've also seen how we can quickly visualize our newly created tags as a quality check. And one last note, tagging can be a memory-intensive process. Make sure you have enough resources dedicated to KNIME before tagging large datasets.